Today, I want to talk about the absolute best Hobbit movie. And I'm not talking out of the best of the bloated Peter Jackson trilogy. I'm talking about the best overall adaptation of the book that I love so intensely. For me, it's by far the 1977 Rankin-Bass production.
The greatest adventure is there if you're bold.
It's a TV movie that only runs for 80 minutes. And it captures the heart and overall story of the novel way better than Hollywood and $600 million ever was able to. I adore this movie. First off, the animation is excellent. You can be disdainful of the low frame rate that sometimes comes on board every now and then, but for a TV movie with a budget of only $3 million, this is magnificent. There's so much detail and lines placed into each of the characters. The dirt and grime that covers them makes them feel more real. This adds so much to the aesthetics of the film, really making it feel like a storybook, more than any clean and sharp animation ever could. There are some problems where the budget cuts are apparent and kind of distracting. For example, when they couldn't animate all the assets of the Battle of the Five Armies, so we get a faraway look at the map to see dots moving around. Even so, in total, I would take this over most bland modern CGI animation. This was created in Japan at a studio called Topcraft. Even after that studio collapsed, the animators working there would eventually form under a man called Hayao Miyazaki, a wonderful company known as Studio Ghibli. That's just to let you know how much talent was actually behind this animation. This iteration of The Hobbit is basically Tolkien, but what if it was an anime? And it's amazing. Look at those beautiful backgrounds that are either infectiously cheerful and warm or deliciously moody. Look at the bizarre creature designs. Have you ever wanted to see giant spiders with big fluffy beards? Goblins that look like they're from a Maurice Sendak book? Or Gollum as a huge frog? Well then all your dreams are coming true thanks to the magic of Rankin-Bass. You can argue these creative liberties on the look of the characters are unfaithful, but I say it overall adds to the aesthetics of telling the story in the anime-fueled lens. And the heart and spirit of the narrative is kept as consistent as possible. True, lots of stuff is skimmed through or skipped through, so it fits in the limited runtime, such as Beorn being entirely cut out, and the Argonstone isn't even mentioned. But this version of The Hobbit still tells the overall story faithfully. Honestly, even seeing the scene with the Jackson version, there's parts of this that are just way better. The Riddles for the Ring sequence in this film is so much more atmospheric and creepy than Jackson's because it's not cutting back and forth. That applies throughout the entire movie, because even if the scenes themselves are short, the time spent on them is comparatively more immersive. This is a focused story centered around Bilbo Baggins, exactly as it should be. Him starting off as the humble dude who just wants to chill and smoke some weed, until Gandalf arrives at his door and sends him on a quest with a ridiculous amount of dwarves. They go through trolls, underhill caverns of goblins, forest spiders, elves, and they finally go to their grand goal of conquering the dragon Smaug and all of his stolen treasure. All while Bilbo grows as a character. His voice actor, Orson Bean, does a good job showing the evolution from humble hobbit to the ring winner and barrel rider.
If you please.
I got to really like this Bilbo over the course of the film, instead of being shoved off into the background half the time. With the short runtime, it feels excusable that the mass of dwarves don't really have any character, like the book. So much to the point that most of them are only voiced by one actors, John DeLeon. The only ones who have unique actors are Dory, Balin, Bomber, and of course, Thorin. Mainly because they're the only ones who have individual scenes with Bilbo that have significance. With John Huston's commanding yet charming presence as Gandalf, Brother Theodore is a legit creepy golem. The voice cast overall is rather excellent. they work perfectly for setting the tone of the kid's story. This movie is still really scary at times, still having more tension riding on it than Jackson's work. But it's also my favorite kind of scary. Kids movie scary. Because that's what The Hobbit is. It's for kids. You shouldn't expect it to be the grand sweeping epic that The Lord of the Rings is. And that's why this film being practically a musical works. The novel is stuffed with songs at every turn. You just had to add music to the lyrics. And damn, some of the tunes in this are simply awesome. I can rock onto them at any time of the day. The only song in here that doesn't come from the text in some shape or form is the song The Greatest Adventure, which is so pure and exciting I've gotten into listening to it whenever I'm about to travel. Other favorites are the Goblin Song, 15 Birds,
15 birds in five fir trees, their feathers were fanned in a fiery breeze,
Barrels Out of Bond, and Rhodes. It just makes the entire film more fun and even more wholesome. Nothing in here betrays the tone or spirit of the novel. One of the book's main themes basically boils down to, don't be a money-grubbing dragon. You know, something that the entire existence of the most well-known adaptation goes completely against. With this, when it's time for them to dish out that message, it still feels genuine. When Thorin says, this?
Child of the kindly West, I have come to know, if more of us valued your ways, food and cheer above hoarded gold, it would be a merrier world.
It's not empty, because we felt the simple cheer that the Hobbit Bilbo Baggins should bring translated onto screen. In total, I find this movie endlessly charming, and as soon as I hear a few notes of The Greatest Adventure, I want to watch it again. If you're someone who found yourself disappointed by Peter Jackson's bloated blob of a trilogy, I highly recommend this wonderful movie, which, even with its minor flaws, is in my eyes the definitive Hobbit adaptation. I'm going to give it a 9.5 out of 10. Thank you so much for watching. This is the second installment in my Middle-earth series. My first video was a short look at the books that all these movies are based on. That link will be in the end card. Next up will be a video discussing Rolf Baschke's Lord of the Rings and a few more of the more seedy Middle-earth films that came out in the 20th century. If you want to be notified when that drops or any of my other upcoming videos, click the bell, and if you aren't already, please subscribe if you feel sufficiently inclined.